My dear respected listeners, today I wish to very, very good morning, and today I wish to deliver you not only engineering physics, but also I want to tell that nature is integrated. Nature does not know which one is physics, which one is chemistry, which one is mathematics, which one is electronics, electrical, mechanical, civil, or your arts topic, or your economics. We are person, we are the human being, we can't apprehend the total infinite integrativeness of nature. We are making it discrete. We are telling some portion is physics, some portion mechanical, some portion electrical, and we are not thinking that nature is actually intermingling each and every way. Nature is bypassing. Now, nature has two equations. Equation number one is, to nature, to us, mission, vision, passion are different. To nature, nature works with that very fundamental formula, mission equal to vision equal to passion equal to creation. This is very, very important thinking about nature. Forget our specialization. Point number two is, object being same, observer being different, the interpretation being changed. Let us tell one or two lines before coming to my subject topic. All of us are made of electron. De Broglie in 1912 told lambda equal to h by 2, h by p, and which is known as the famous de Broglie wave particle simultaneity. That is, wave and particle, they are not discrete, they are simultaneous, just Ardhanarishwar Murti of Shivaji. Then came Pauli. He says electron has spin, it should be added externally, and Pauli says sharing principle of spin of Pauli. Then came Dirac. Dirac says all are wrong, solve my differential equation, which is Dirac differential equation, spin will come automatically as a solution. Space scientist says all are wrong, solve Schrodinger differential equation in five dimensions, spin will automatically come. What we realize, object being same, that is electron, observer being different. First case, it was de Broglie, second Pauli, third Dirac, all of them are no laureate, and fourth Houghton. Observers are different, interpretation is changing. To some of you, I am a good lecturer, to some of you, I am a bad lecturer, and to some of you, I am more than worse. With this simple preambling, you are not going to see engineering physics, and it starts from very simple principle of variation of class 10. Let us start with zero level. We know if there are two quantities A and B, and if they vary directly, A varies directly as B. This is called the so much principle of direct variation of two numbers. It is of class 10 model. Therefore, A equal to some constant into B. K is the constant of variation. My dear listeners, you will not believe this is all of physics, all of chemistry, all of mathematics, all of engineering. How come? I am telling. One person came whose name is Ohm. He says, put A equal to B, put K equal to R, and put B equal to Y, which is a simple Ohm's law, as you know. Another person came, his name is Faraday. He says, put A equal to B, put K equal to L, and put B equal to di dt. It is called the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. It is inductance voltage. The constant is resistance in the first case of Ohm's law, which is known as Ohm's law, and it is Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. And this is back EMF, and L is called the inductance of the system, unit Henry. Is that all? Surely no. Then came our famous Isaac Newton. He says, put A equal to P, put K equal to M, and put B equal to F. It is nothing but Newton's second law. How fine whole thing is. Then came again Newton. He says, put A equal to P1, put K equal to minus 1, and put B equal to P2. It is Newton's third law. Two forces equal in magnitude but opposite in direction must balance each other. Then came, let us put A equal to sigma MVI, I equal to 1 to infinity, and put K equal to 0. This is laws of conservation of linear momentum. Again, we want to put A equal to I omega I and K equal to 0. This is the laws of conservation of angular momentum. We realize as the system changes, physics changes, mathematics changes, everything changes. If we put A equal to PV to the power gamma, B equal to 1, it is simple, our gas law of thermodynamics. Everything can be adjusted from simply A equal to KB or A varies as B, which is the laws of variation. Domains are different. If I put A equal to stress, K equal to Young's modulus, and our B equal to strain, it is our Young's law, Hooke's law of elasticity. Subject being same, observer being different, whole interpretation changes. This sentence I told in the very first. Now go to van der Waal. Put P equal to A by V square, V minus B. K equal to RT and B equal to 1. It is simple van der Waal's equation, as you often see. You will not believe whole physics, whole mathematics, whole chemistry is the consequence of A equal to KB. Now the mathematician comes. He says, put A equal to Y, put K equal to M, put B equal to X. It is the straight line passing through the origin. Let us draw the graph. This is Y, this is X, just simple coordinate geometry. This straight line passing through first quadrant and third quadrant. Therefore, all other things are the special case of A equal to KB and Y equal to MX. Learning only one line. Nature to the first order is linear in nature. Nature does not know, I have told you as the first of my starting, what is physics, what is chemistry, what is mathematics, what is engineering, what is arts and what is commerce. Nature has got a problem. We have to solve it. Nature is integrated. We are the person. Without understanding the totality of nature, we want to subdivide it. But subdivision sometimes gives us a big problem. One line understanding of all lecture is nature to the first order is linear in nature, and that I write. Nature to the first order is linear in nature. Answer is, I repeat it. Now, is that all? Surely no. We can go to an half extent. That is called nonlinearity. Everything becomes nonlinear. If we take a string and extend it too much, it will not be forces proportional to distance. It will be nonlinear. Circuit theory, it is nonlinear. Your communication is nonlinear. Nonlinear nature is the extremely important branch of our whole knowledge domain. We can get nonlinear strength of material, we can get nonlinear elasticity, we can get nonlinear circuit theory, we can get nonlinear communication. Everything from linearity goes to nonlinearity, and that is nature actual. To make our mathematics very simple, we make everything linear, although it expresses a vast domain of knowledge. But to nature, you will not believe, nature to the first order is linear in nature. Although nature is basically non-linear. Thus, we observe nature to the first order is linear in nature, although nature is basically non-linear.